Good morning. Please stand for the presentation of colors by the Maricopa and Gila River Police Department's Honor Guard and the singing of our national anthem by Johnny Huerta of the Tolleson Police Department.
Police officers, veterans, attention! Present arms!
Thank you to the Maricopa and Gila River Police Department's Honor Guard and Johnny Huerta. I think you both deserve a great round of applause. Great job. Please be seated. Good morning. My name is Anthony Vasquez, and I'm the commander of the Phoenix Regional Police Academy. I would like to welcome you this morning as we celebrate the graduation of Class 538, and to our online folks, family and friends, thank you for joining us for this special occasion. It is my privilege to introduce the sergeant for Class 538. Each graduating class at our academy owes a large part of their success to the dedication and effort of their class sergeant. For Class 538, that leadership was provided by Sergeant Tony Cardinelli. Sergeant Cardinelli has worked for the Gila River Police Department for the past 12 years. In February 2008, he attended the Arizona Law Enforcement Academy as a proud member of Class 439. After graduation, he worked assignments in patrol, rangers, the community response team, and background in hiring. Sergeant Cardinelli has obtained certification and instructs firearms, patrol rifle, taser, and was part of the team that implemented the Gila River Public Safety Immediate Threat Intervention Program instructing fire and EMS personnel to work alongside law enforcement officers. Sergeant Cardinelli was promoted to the rank of sergeant in 2016 and has served in patrol, the Fugitive Apprehension Unit, and Criminal Investigations Bureau. He has also served 10 years on the SWAT team as a sniper, team leader, and is currently the team commander. Sergeant Cardinelli is a United States Marine Corps veteran and a current student at Columbia Southern University. Tony has also been married to his wife, Jennifer, for the past 4 years. This is Sergeant Cardinelli's first recruit class. I present to you the basic training sergeant for class 538, Sergeant Tony Cardinelli.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sergeant Tony Cardinelli of the Gila River Police Department, and I am the class sergeant for class 538 here at PRPA. On behalf of the Phoenix Regional Police Academy, I'd like to welcome you and your loved ones to our graduation ceremony, and thank you for taking the time to come and honor these men and women for their hard work and dedication. A special welcome to the family and friends joining us remotely. I'd like to personally thank the Phoenix Police Public Affairs Bureau for their help with that. Back on March 16th, my staff and I were provided 27 recruits from 12 different law enforcement agencies across the state. This diverse group of agencies represents tribal, county, university, and local law enforcement. We were tasked with providing them over 585 hours of basic law enforcement training required by the Arizona Peace Officer Standards and Training Board. These standards are very high, and of the original 27 recruits of Class 538, 23 are graduating here today. As you can imagine, they came to us as individuals with different fitness levels, different attitudes, different backgrounds, and different personalities. 18 weeks ago, during my orientation speech to the class, I explained that we do not hand out badges here at PRPA, and that each of them must earn the right to wear one. I asked each of them to give me 100% of their effort at all times and to dedicate themselves to achieving the expectations set forth by this academy, our governing body at POST, and most importantly, by the citizens of this great state. On day one of their academy tenure, the recruits introduced themselves to staff and explained why they have chosen to pursue a career in law enforcement. Some said they wanted to be a protector or role model for their children and families. Others said it was a fulfillment of a lifelong goal. The most overwhelming response was a desire to serve and protect their communities with the hopes of making them a safer place to live. Thanks to their hard work and perseverance over 18 weeks, that opportunity is now theirs. In week one, they were directed to write an autobiography. Those papers gave my staff and I the opportunity to get to know the recruits. Those bios showed the true range of human experience. Several recruits had rural upbringings, never leaving their hometown. Other recruits traveled the world with their families, never staying put for more than a couple of years. Some endured very hard economic times and are surviving children of divorce. Some have served in our nation's armed forces in countries such as Afghanistan, Iraq, and other remote areas. Many have gone on to further their education and obtain their bachelor's or associate's degrees. Others have volunteered their time as coaches, counselors, and overcome countless hurdles to get them where they are today. Throughout our process, many of them identified personal weaknesses and struggled to improve in those areas. Others faced and conquered personal fears for the first time. They've made lifelong friends and learned to work as a team. This closeness has bonded them much like a family. I can only imagine the stories you've heard about the last 18 weeks and their first day and those experiences here in the early days at PRPA. By design, this process is intended to be stressful and highly demanding. The staff of Class 538 has pushed many of them to their extremes of physical, mental, and emotional fitness. Over the last 18 weeks, the recruits of Class 538 have endured a wide variety of training intended to instill discipline, proficiency, and confidence. They've received countless hours of academic instruction, proficiency training in defensive tactics, firearms, and tactical driving. We have forced them to demonstrate their understanding of these things through scenario-based training. As a result of their experience at the academy, phrases or words like lock your body, respond, and pain retains will forever be etched in their memories. The delivery of their training served a much larger purpose, though. Class 538 will be relentless in their pursuit of justice, attentive to every detail in their daily tasks, and ever mindful of the laws, rules, and policies that govern their conduct as peace officers. The recruits in Class 538 are not average people. They're a special breed that have a common desire to serve a greater cause that's greater than themselves in order to ensure the safety and welfare of their communities. They want to make a difference. They understand and are willing to accept danger as part of their daily lives. They're willing to do a very difficult job that most are not able to do with little to no thanks. For that, you have my sincere gratitude, and I'm proud now to call you brothers and sisters. Finally, I would like to thank each member of the class for your enthusiasm and dedication to excellence. I have thoroughly enjoyed leading you through the first phase of your career. Keep in mind, this is only the beginning of your journey. As you enter the field of law enforcement, remember who you are and what you represent. You are the future of our profession and the leaders of tomorrow. The ideals that we have instilled in you, integrity, honor, and pride, are not just things we adhere to here at the Academy. They are the foundation of a successful career. More importantly, they are what your communities expect of you. Always remember to be to those whom much is given, much is asked. Be humble, be mindful, seek out the best in others, but be mindful of your training. Do your best to make a positive impact in the lives of those people you will meet. Make sure to go home to your families at the end of the day and leave the stresses of this job at the door. I'm very proud of each of you and excited for where you will go from here. Congratulations to you all. Good luck. And above all, be safe out there. At this time, I would like to recognize the recruit training officers from Class 538. Over the past several months, these four individuals have worked tirelessly to ensure the implementation of Academy curriculum, and I truly feel that they are the biggest reason for the success of Class 538. They are the foundation of the training staff, and I would not have been able to get this job done without them. They have put in countless hours over the last several months. They have been mentors and role models for the recruits, and they've helped me ensure we have provided the best training possible. The success of class would not have been possible without their hard work, dedication, professionalism, and commitment to this training. I have relied on their knowledge and expertise on many occasions over the past 18 weeks. I would like to publicly thank them now. RTOs, front and center.
Ready? Push! All right! Push!
As the lead RTO from Class 538, representing the Phoenix Police Department, Officer Mike Melhouse. Representing the Gilbert Police Department, Recruit Training Officer Brett Archibald. Representing the Avondale Police Department, Recruit Training Officer Caesar Athone. Representing the Gila River Police Department, Recruit Training Officer Jason Greeley. Thank you, gentlemen. It was an honor. Now I have the honor of introducing the class speaker. Over the last 18 weeks, this individual has earned the respect of his fellow classmates, his staff, and I. Representing Class 538 and the Gila River Police Department, Officer James Nelson.
Good afternoon. I'd like to thank everyone for being here. or virtually tuning in to this special event today. I'd also like to give an extra thank you to the command staff for coordinating this event. Between the COVID-19 restrictions and the constant schedule changes, I know this has not been easy. I'd also like to extend a special thank you to the command staff that's representing the graduating agencies today. My name is James Nelson, and I'm a recruit with Class 538. My class chose me to be the speaker today, and I'm very honored to have that privilege. In life, we all have events that will forever be etched in our memory. If we all think back, you can often identify events that you will never forget. The last 18 weeks have left countless memories that will stick with us forever. All the recruits that you see here today are driven for one reason or another. For some of us, it is to be a positive role model to our young children and families. For some of us, it is to be the change within our communities. And for others still, it is because we made a promise to a family or friend that is no longer with us. But whatever the reason, whatever the sacrifices we have made, it was worth it. There is a question that gets asked sometimes that if you could go back in time and change something in your life, what would it be? If you asked any of these recruits that question, I think their answer would all be the same. If we could go back and change one thing in our lives, it would be that we would change nothing at all. It is because of the decisions that we have made in life and the events that have taken place that have led us to this moment. The hard times that we thought we could not make it through, the moments of joy and elation, and even when we had to be picked up, dusted off by our friends and family, and pointed in the correct direction again. We've all had those moments, and all of those moments have led us here. And this is exactly where we want to be. Every single one of us got into this career to help people, even on their worst days, because at some point, somebody showed up for ours. Without the family and friends that have impacted our lives and believed in us, we wouldn't be here. Now, we've had a few bumps in the road in the last 18 weeks to get to this point, but every good journey starts with a single step. For most of us, that first step was shaky and filled with nerves. Some of us had an idea of what to expect and what it might be like, but I don't think any of us were ready for what was to come. Some mistakes were made early on, like wearing skinny jeans that were tan in color to the second day of the academy. And forgetting that we always had to have all uniforms on deck at all times. Regardless of this, we moved through these long process and weeks and were led by a fearless sergeant and RTOs that had only the best of intentions for us. Even if they chose to show up by screaming until they lost their voice. They made the academy one of the biggest challenges many of us had ever faced, pushing us to our limits and making us stronger and harder than we were when we arrived on day one. As the class progressed to the academy, the recruits had a few conversations about the RTOs. A lot of those different topics came up in these conversations, such as, why does RTO Mailhouse look like M&M? And how does RTO Greeley always see us twitch while we're in formation? Is RTO Archibald always this angry? And is RTO Athone secretly a silent ninja? But behind every dog park visit and DTC appointment, we had a lesson given to us. Sometimes it was about teamwork or finding the individual strength inside of you to fight through any amount of pain. As a class, we had a very memorable lesson about racking our slides in the locker room. But behind every invisible chair and every front-leaning rest, we became better, stronger, and more prepared for the next step in this academy and our future careers. As we progressed in the academy, we started to work as a team, helping each other when we struggled or fell behind. More than a few times, I can recall someone in class giving a supportive word or an assisting hand reaching out when we needed it. Knowing that we could reach out to any of our classmates for some help was always reassuring. Just don't have your little sister reach out to Sergeant Cardinelli over Facebook. Our staff taught us how strong we are inside, so that one day when we need to stay in the fight, or when we need to fight for someone else, we will know that we are stronger than anything we could face and more dedicated than the person who is trying to confront us. Sergeant Cardinelli, RTO Melhouse, RTO Greeley, RTO Archibald, and RTO Athone, we as Class 538 want you to know that through the lessons that you have taught us, through the examples of dedication and selflessness that you have shown us, we are in your debt. We want you to know that your influence will always be with us as we depart for our respective agencies, and your determination will guide and guidance will spread across this great state of Arizona and continue to shape us through our careers. Your insistence on our greatness will filter out in the way we conduct ourselves as officers and the lives that we will change and save because of the things that you have taught us here. Thank you for your service. Thank you for making us the best we could possibly be. There is only one Class 538. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Jennifer Borquez, and I'm the captain with the Arizona Department of Public Safety and the executive officer of Class 538. Every individual of Class 538 has worked hard to achieve their goal of becoming peace officers. I would, however, like to take the opportunity to recognize a few individuals who have demonstrated exceptional performance within five categories during their time at the academy. The first award is in the area of academics. Throughout the academy, the students experienced over 700 hours of training to include 49 tests and an overall comprehensive final exam. The award for top recruit in the area of academics is presented to the student with the highest academic average. With an overall average score of 95%, representing the Coconino County Sheriff's Office, recruit Daniel Flores. The next award is for firearms. This award is presented to the student with the highest combined score from 2-day and 2-night qualifications. With an overall score of 250 out of a possible 250 points, representing the Gila River Police Department, recruit James Nelson. Next is the award for top recruit in the area of physical fitness. This is presented to the student with the highest physical fitness scores throughout their academy training. With an overall percentage of 92.95%, representing the Avondale Police Department, recruit Richard Miranda. The award for top overall recruit is presented to the recruit who has demonstrated the most versatility in the areas of firearms, physical fitness, and academics, with a combined average score of 92.78%, representing the Avondale Police Department, recruit Richard Miranda. The final category is for exemplary recruit. This recognition is given to an individual chosen by the rest of their class. The class voted by secret ballot for the recruit they believe represents the spirit of the class through leadership, humility, integrity, and determination. The result of their vote remains secret until this moment. Representing the Gila River Police Department, recruit James Nelson. Please join me in congratulating all of the award winners as they return to their seats. The recruits in Class 538 have completed some of the most impactful training of their career. Their experiences at the academy will last a lifetime. They have been pushed mentally, physically, and academically. They have experienced varying levels of adversity and have demonstrated proficiency in areas that will serve them well in their new roles in their respective communities. You have likely seen this transformation into the complex world of policing and public service take place. Many of you have shared in the joys, frustrations, and challenges of your loved ones, but you haven't quite experienced their day-to-day life at the Academy. The staff of Class 538 would like to share some of these moments with you in a class video. We hope you enjoy.
Doing sit-ups, and they asked him, how many sit-ups do you do? And he said, I don't start counting until it hurts. Now think about that. He doesn't start counting his sit-ups until he feels pain. That's when he starts counting. That is working hard. There is no magic pill. There is no magic out there. So you work hard, and then you let the world know about your work. That's what it is all about.
Miserable day, you will come home to a bed that is made, that you made. And a made bed gives you encouragement that tomorrow will be better. To pass SEAL training, there are a series of long swims that must be completed. One is the night swim. Before the swim, the instructors joyfully brief the students on all the species of sharks that inhabit the waters off San Clemente. They assure you, however, that no student has ever been eaten by a shark, at least not that they can remember. But you are also taught that if a shark begins to circle your position, stand your ground. Do not swim away. Do not act afraid. And if a shark, hungry for a midnight snack, darts towards you, then summons up all your strength and punch him in the snout, and he will turn and swim away. There are a lot of sharks in the world. If you hope to complete the swim, you will have to deal with them. So if you want to change the world, don't back down from the sharks. If you want to change the world, measure a person by the size of their heart, by the size of their flippers. If I have learned anything in my time traveling the world, it is the power of hope. The power of one person. One person can change the world by giving people hope. So if you want to change the world, start each day with a task completed. Find someone to help you through life. Respect everyone. Know that life is not fair and that you will fail often. But if you take some risks, step up when the times are the toughest, face down the bullies, lift up the downtrodden, and never, ever give up. If you do these things, the next generation and the generations that follow will live in a world far better than the one we have today. And what started here will indeed have changed the world for the better.
Hey, little brother. Just want to let you know, congratulations. Good job. I love you. See you.
Hi, Chris. We knew you could do it. Good luck with your future endeavors. We love you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Aaron. You did it. We love you. We're proud of you.
Felicidades, mijo. Estamos muy orgullosos de ti.
Congratulations, Larry. We are so proud of you and we love you. And remember, God will always be with you in your innermost dream of the future.
Congratulations, Larry. Yes, we are proud of you. Remember what I always taught you. Strive not to equal, but to excel. We're proud of you, boy.
So congratulations, Laura! Impressive achievement. Some girl.
I'm so proud of you.
Ian, Emery, and I are so proud of everything you have accomplished. Your life is going to be great for you. We can't wait to celebrate with you. We love you.
You did it. I'm so grateful for you and everything that you do for us. I love you very much. Great job.
I just want to tell you I'm proud of you. I wish you the best because you're the best. And congratulations. I love you.
Bye. Love you.
Hello. We'd like to congratulate Renee Ordonez on graduating from the Arizona Police Academy.
Love you, dude.
Love you. Congratulations.
Hola, papi. You did it. We are so proud of you. We know it's been a long 18 weeks and lots of sacrifices, but you did it. We love you so, so much. Bye, Daddy. I love you.
Hey, buddy. It's Mom and Sophia. Surprise. Congratulations.
What a great putting that together for our family and friends that helped contribute to it. We want to thank you for that also. So now is the time for the badge presentation. If the chiefs could please make their way up to the front of the room at this time. Okay, in class. Presenting the badges for the Arizona State University Police Department, Assistant Chief Stuart Bedix. And the first badge. The first badge being presented to Jesse Kachasi. Ian Kennedy. Jordan Mamoy. Ian Moreno. Edgar Rodriguez. Presenting the badges for the Avondale Police Department, Chief Dale Nanigay. Jeffrey Feldposh. Bogdan Hudorowicz. Fritz Mendiola. Richard Miranda. Thank you. Presenting the badges for the Coconino County Sheriff's Office, Sheriff Jim Driscoll. Daniel Flores. Nathan Trujillo. Thank you. Presenting the badges for the Flagstaff Police Department, Deputy Chief Dan Musselman. Jason Wynn. presenting the badges for the Gila River Police Department, Assistant Chief William Morago, Aaron Hernandez. Andrew Mixis. James Nelson. Garrett Saraceno. Thank you. Presenting the badges for the Gilbert Police Department, Assistant Chief Mike Angstead. Laura Johnson. Presenting the badges for the Hualapai Nation Police Department, Chief Frederick Smith. Ty Atherton. Christopher Ganeau. Presenting the badges for the Maricopa Police Department, Sergeant Tony Cardinelli. Larry Hauser. Renee Ordonez. Thank you. Presenting the badges for the Northern Arizona University Police Department, Chief Kelly Smith. Leander Adson. And presenting the badges for the Tolleson Police Department, Chief Wayne Boer. Diana Rivas.
We have reached the time in the ceremony for badge pinning. The new officer has selected someone of significance to pin their badge on their uniform for the very first time. Someone who has been with them through the ups and downs of life and someone who will be there now and throughout their challenging career. The badge pinning process will be completed by squad designation. Can I please have squad one to the front of the room? At this time, I would like to invite the selected family member or friend to the front of the room to join your loved one.
Ready? Face!
Thank you, family and loved ones. Thank you, Squad One. Can I please have Squad 2 to the front of the room? At this time, I would like to invite the selected family members or friends to the front of the room to join your loved one. Thank you, family and loved ones. Thank you, Squad 2. Can I please have squad 3 to the front of the room? At this time, I would like to invite the selected family members or friends to the front of the room to join your loved ones.
Ready? Face.
Thank you, family and loved ones. Thank you, Squad 3. Can I please have Squad 4 to the front of the room? At this time, I would like to invite the selected family members or friends to the front of the room to join your loved ones. Thank you, family and loved ones. Thank you, Squad 4. The badge represents the authority and honor of all who have served as peace officers, past and present. It is worn over the heart as a reminder of their oath and pledge of service to the community. At this time, we will be conducting the oath of office to swear in and affirm Class 538. Class 538, please make your way to the front of the room. Here to administer the oath is the Honorable John Ellsworth from the Casa Grande Justice Court. Judge Ellsworth started his law enforcement career in 1973 as a law enforcement specialist in the U.S. Air Force. He was a sworn Arizona peace officer for a combined 36 years. Judge Ellsworth worked for the Casa Grande Police Department, the Arizona Department of Corrections Criminal Investigations Unit, and he retired at the rank of lieutenant as the operations commander of the Pinal County Sheriff's Office Criminal Investigations Bureau. He is currently serving his second term as the Casa Grande Justice of the Peace. Please welcome Judge Ellsworth.
Ready, face!
We want you to stay at attention. I just asked you a question. We want you to stay at attention.
Yes, sir.
I'm very pleased to be here. The oath of office represents a trust between society and the peace officer. The oath of office for the peace officer is the binding representation of this trust. A trust that is dedication to our policing profession, our fellow police officers, your agency, and most importantly, the citizens that you serve. I'm going to add in that this oath does not expire. I also would like to add in a few words. I think most, if not all, the law enforcement leadership in here is going to agree with me that the absolute funnest and best time of my whole career was when I was a sergeant working at night on the streets with a squad of go-getters. And so I would like to say a few words to you before I administer the oath. And if you don't mind, I'm going to speak like an old sergeant. The very highest priority that you have is to go home vertical at the end of your shift with the same amount of holes in your body that you reported with. Secondly, ethics. I want you to hang on to that. Ethics. I know for a fact that you're going to be stopped by somebody right outside these gates, these walls, and they're going to ask you an ethical question. And you're going to be able to tell them whether it's ethically correct or not, and more importantly, you're going to be able to tell them why. Yeah, hang on to that. Last, integrity. You all know somebody can take your life. Somebody can steal your car. Somebody can take your dog. But nobody can take away your integrity. You have to give that up yourself. Hang on to your integrity. Hang on to those three items I talked about. Please remember them. Now please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, state your name.
I, Diana Rivas.
I, Jason Wynn.
I, Chris Gano.
I, Edgar Rodriguez.
I, Jordan Malmoy.
I, Leander Adson.
I, Ian Kennedy.
I, Richard Miranda III.
I, Laura Johnson.
I, Jesse Patrese.
I, French Mandiola.
I, Larry Hauser.
I, Jeffrey Feldbosch.
I, Ian Moreno.
I, Daniel Flores.
I, Andrew Mixes.
I, Garrett Cerecino.
I, Rene Ordonez.
I, Aaron Hernandez.
I, Nathaniel Trujillo.
I, Bogdan Hodorowicz.
I, Ty Atherton.
I, James Nelson.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws of the State of Arizona.
And the Constitution and laws of the State of Arizona.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to same.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance to same.
And defend them.
And defend them.
Against enemies.
Against enemies.
Foreign and domestic.
Foreign and domestic.
And that I will faithfully and impartially
That I will faithfully and impartially
discharge the duties of a peace officer.
Discharge the duties of a peace officer.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much.
This concludes our graduation ceremony
for Class 538. To the family and friends of Class 538, I want to thank you for your understanding during this unprecedented time, and thank you for all of the support you have provided to each member of our class. Our family and friends are crucial to bring us balance and focus as we fulfill our roles as public servants. To Class 538, I want to congratulate you for completing the first step in your journey as a police officer. This is a noble profession, and your actions reflect on every officer who wears the badge. Represent yourself, your department, and your community with honor and integrity. Today, you earn the privilege and the right to wear the badge. Struggles and difficulties are not meant to discourage you. They are here to help you realize what is truly important. This should show you that you can accomplish anything you want as long as you are willing to work hard. Congratulations, Class 538. Good luck, God bless, and be safe. Sergeant Cardinelli, please come forward and dismiss your class for the final time.